Hello everyone and welcome back to Sousa Plays. Some more Blood Bowl with the Harbingers of Annoyance. Our Nurgle team, no levels yet and no wins yet. So Nurgle is a hard team to start off. They are pretty much probably the weakest team in Blood Bowl 2 if you go with the starting team. And I think I might have been better off starting with the Beast Nurgle instead of going with four Nurgle Warriors and Pestigors. Or maybe gone for the third reroll. One of those options would probably have been better than my start. But then again, I've never played them before, so how would I know? Well, I could have asked someone who knew. But how would I know? That's my story and I'm sticking to it. So let's just play until we can afford to buy the Beast or the reroll and see where we go from there. There's been a couple of days since we gave... Oh, 2 seconds off the spin. Well, anyway. There's been a couple of days since the Nurgle release. Hopefully the wave of fresh Nurgle teams have subsided a little bit so we don't only play against other Nurgle. It would be nice to see how we fare against other teams. Then again, that would probably be a tougher matchup since Nurgle are so weak at the start. But yeah, variation is... Well, it's better than playing the same thing over and over again, even if that gives you a better option. At least in my opinion. So I will make a quick break here and bring you back once we find who we will play against today. And we found ourselves some Lizardmen. It's not going to be Nurgle versus Nurgle today. Well, Lizard's going to be tough to deal with, of course. Especially since they have some block on the Croxigor as well. He has won his four first games with this team. 0-0. Hopefully that won't be today's score. And we get some petty cash. What would be good? An extra reroll, I think, is probably our best bet here. I don't normally go for the extra team training, but since rerolls are expensive as Nurgle and we are running lower than we would actually want, I think the extra team training will be better than two babes or a bribe. For a bribe to work, we'd have to actually be able to knock them down. They have strength 4 for everybody we will be available to hit, and if we get the skink, then the skink dodges and we won't get them anyway. But we'll see. Oh, it's raining. Lovely. Good thing we got an extra reroll. So, well, I will start on defense if I get the option to choose, because I don't want to pick up in the rain. And neither will he. I don't think he had any agility skills on the skinks. Okay, so let's defend for best ability. Yeah, should we put one Nurgle Warrior on the line? Hope for him wasting time with Disturbing Presence. He has block and strength, enough strength to knock us down. Would maybe commit a lot of Saurus, but he has more Saurus than we have Warriors, so I think we just go with the standard here. I like the symmetry of having 3 Rotters, 4 Warriors, 4 Pestigors. It looks really good when you set up. But I guess that's not your main concern when you're on level. So he'll probably take block hits on all 3 here. No, he's gonna blitz with one of the Sources. Rude boy. Joker Smoker. We have one Love, Rustaman, Ganja Farmer, and Badman. And the Croxigor is called Mr. Phipps. Money in the bank. Payday. Give me the cash. Money in the bank. I get it. And black check. Okay, so that's the theme for them. Did I miss anything here? Rest of my Landman 1 Lab? No? I don't think so. I like it when people name their players. He gets an extra reroll. Hopefully he burns it on the pickup. He starts with the pickup, but we can't expect to get that lucky. Long kick, that's not great. He has the speed, so he will be able to pick that up. I don't think that was necessary, really. I guess it gives him another chance if he fails to pick up. He doesn't need to pull everybody back here. Then again, they're quick enough that he can get all the way forward. It's not like I'm gonna steal the ball if he fails to pick up back there. If it had been on the outside here, well, then it would be even worse to move them back, because then if he fails it out and it lands somewhere else, then everybody's in the wrong position. Okay, he's very, very concerned about this pickup. I think this is, well, I wouldn't have moved all the skinks. Moving back two sauruses to about here would have probably been enough. Then kept the skinks where they were and then tried to pick it up. Okay, this is too much. Gearing up field position. He's totally giving up on trying to hit us. Maybe he doesn't believe in his chance to remove anyone with regen. If that's the case, he should try to hit these decayers instead. And then he moved one guy in. Without blitzing. So no blitz coming. No hit either. Wow. And he made a pickup. A lot of work for nothing there. Well, in this situation I kinda wish I had a bribe, because now we can knock one of these down and have stomp on them. We should probably still stomp on the Croxivore if we get a chance. A blocked Croxivore is very useful. So I think I can afford to try and hit here. Now this would be a one die, so we need an assist for that. I'll bring a Nurgle Warrior up to here. Let's still keep a little bit of width. I also want one Pestigore to stay behind as a safety. We can hopefully get a skink. We should probably even keep two back. And then we blitz, but first this guy stands up. I'll mark the Croxivore with him. Should I blitz the Croxivore or should I blitz this fella? 4 or 5. I need another assist to blitz the Croxivore. Let's blitz the Croxy. This is not too bad, even if it should fail. Alright, that's very good. And if I do this, and then hope to get an armor break here. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You can get around if you push into there. Nice hit, no break. The stomp on the Croxigore would now be 72%. So I'll risk one of the Pestigores to get it up to 80. And then bring this guy out here so we can't just take this side. This looks pretty good. Let's go ahead and foul the Croxigore. Hopefully the ref doesn't notice. But I would take a scent off Rotter versus a removed Croxigore. Well, we get neither. Fair enough. But we got a stun out of it. I'm not gonna push forward. I should probably have pushed forward a little bit further. Could have gone up here. But the Pestigore's around there. One of them over the move. Okay, he moves up. That was the ball carrier. So he's trusting that he can knock this guy out of the way then. Otherwise he had no cage. This guy has won 4 games, so he's probably not the worst.
I would hope.
Good to move everybody before you do your blitz here. Of course, moving can't fail unless you make GFIs. This is safe, we can't get past 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, we can't reach the back of that, so he doesn't really need to put a player here. But I have a feeling he will, he seems to be very keen on protecting the ball, from what I've seen so far. He's tagging the Pestigore, not a bad move. Unless his player blitz it, but I think he's blitzing this. Yes. Should probably have blitzed with the guy with lock. But that's a push. Alright. Alright. Lots of contact. Doesn't want me fouling again. I could bring up only one assist. I could bring a second assist, I suppose. And then push him away. Then I'd have a two die there. I could also mark him and have a two die there. If it's a knockdown, I could even chain push one of the others off. Can I get to him? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I could get a shot at the ball if I don't use this guy. Instead, use this guy for the assists. He needs to go here though, and this needs to be a knockdown, and then 1, 2, 3, well, if I make the other stand there, nah, he would be in the way, right? No, I could get through, it's a possibility. Okay, let's risk it. So this needs to be there, and this needs to be there. That's plus 2. Meaning 3 strength hits for enough. Okay, let's go for it. It is a knockdown. Now let's see. I need to put him here so I can run around him. I can't follow. Actually, I could follow. Yeah, I should probably follow. And now... No, I miscounted. I can't reach him. Oh, right, I need to knock him down, and then I could have gone through here, maybe. Yeah, but now I've messed it up. Okay, let's knock this guy down, then. Ooh. Well, we do have 3 rerolls, I think we need that. Well, I need to push him, but do I keep it on? No, that would free him up. Better to have one caught with no hit than to have one caught with a hit. Two assists on the foul now. We'll move in here. I guess we blitz like the stink instead. It's probably a better idea than this hit. Stop by doing this. No, no luck blitzing stinks. I don't think that's something we're going to have. I can hit him, I can hit him. I'm gonna hit this guy. This is a knockdown, which it is. I could push him, but he'd end up there, so I'm gonna push him here instead. And now we have 3 assists on this foul. Do I wanna make a 3 assist foul? 32. We are slightly above 50% to break armor. Oh. I decided not to. Or the timer decided for me. I have to remember 2-minute turns. When you're talking, 2 minutes go much faster. Yeah, you can gain a bit of ground here. That rotor hit was always coming. He looks to be... Now he's putting everybody in contact. In the beginning he looked very, very cautious and tried to disengage. That'll be a two die. Hopefully we get our foul appearance. There's the blitz though. Ooh, turnover. He has four rerolls, so he's not gonna worry about that. That's a problem. He's gonna follow there, most likely. Could blitz our way out of that. Then we're not blitzing the ball. Ooh, double skulls. What is this move? And a knockout, that's super lucky. Well, it means we have a free shot on the ball here. Two die. Can we make it a three die? We need to get someone else up there. We need to dodge this fella. So if we did that first, that's only a 1 in 3 of working, actually. I could 3-die this skink, that's probably worth it. I don't have a 2-die on him. But if I took the 1-die on him, and got a push, or better, I could then hit the Croxigore. I could hit the Croxigore first, actually. From there. And then I'd have a 2-die there. That's probably better. But the shot on the ball is gonna have to go first. I don't think we can make it a 3-die. But him dropping the ball is great in the rain. He might have to spend some rerolls picking it up on a 50-50. Nope. We reroll this. I can't afford to reroll that. I'm gonna take the push and follow. Actually, did I have one more step? I think I did. No, I didn't. Shoot. I'm gonna try anyway. Oh. Well, I am gonna reroll that because I need to do some other stuff. Otherwise, it probably goes through here. Well, that's too bad. Good thing I didn't reroll the block, because then there would have been a double skull. So he goes out. That's what I was hoping to prevent by failing a dodge there later, after taking some 2-die hits. And all that because I thought I had one more step. Should just follow that and be two skinks. I wanted to be just on one skink, so you had to move the other skink if you wanted to hit. If I was there, he could have hit with the other skink and then had it move the ball carrier still. But, you know, if you miscount and then roll two ones, you're not going to make it. So now he could run through here. Can he make it safe? He can put skinks in the way. Also stun the Nurgle warrior. He is going for it, so looks like he's trying to score quickly then. It's a bit unsafe. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Well, he's gonna put someone in between, surely. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2. We have to dodge twice if we want to get down. Oh, now that's not a possibility anymore. And he's gonna put someone in between, of course. He needs one GFI to score from there. Maybe he'll fail his GFI twice. Just kidding, no one fails two GFIs in a row. There he is. Oh, I'd love it if he dodged. Maybe if we get these two down, we could run around here with one dodge and hit him from behind. All appearance, hey! Nice. Sounds not nice. Ooh, well, no, that's just the blood source. At least he didn't tie up the warrior. Can the Croxigore, yeah, the Croxigore can hit him. Unless he boneheads and lets two of us free for free. Oh, he rerolled the bonehead. Wow. Didn't he already spend his reroll this turn? No. Well, that's a knocked out lottery instead then. It's down to two rerolls. We're not gonna dodge another warrior. Did I call them Chaos Warriors? Someone said that Nurgle are Chaos, technically, but I still want to say Nurgle Warriors instead of Chaos Warriors, just to keep it clear what I'm talking about. We can't blitz one of these and get through. We could blitz him, and then we had to GFI to actually mark the ball carrier. We could not get a hit unless we mark him. Get a plus one for the proxy lore. It's a one die on the prox. Or a one die on him. I did this. Two GFIs to have a two die on him. But that doesn't get me the ball carrier. Okay, let's do something here. You stand up, you come in here. I'm gonna try to put some pressure up here so he scores quickly. I kind of have a feeling he will score quickly anyway, but I want to make sure. I can't afford to reroll that, unfortunately. Oh, Red probably dead. Will he regen? Yes. Okay, that's lucky. So I can't complain. But, as you can see, 3 reroll was not enough. Yeah, he's gonna stall. That's what I was trying to prevent by putting a Pestigore down here. Hoping that he wouldn't dare just try to hit the Pestigore. And where a failure would have meant it's in the ball carrier. So now we're looking on a turn at a turn 8 score. I don't think being down 3 players, and down 2 players, I don't think with being down 2 players that we can break away from the 7 strength 4 and 5s. We have 8 versus 7 if he keeps all his skinks down here. So technically we could break 1-3, but his combined strength is in his favor. And one of us is stunned. Hit him? No, he's gonna hit Pestigore. Didn't get around to doing that one die block. Can't make one die block if you fail your two die blocks. It's a one die. We have to make it a two die since he didn't hit this Lotto instead. You do Pestigore is okay. They do have regen as we just witnessed, but they have the same armor as the Rotters, and they are more useful. Hey, foul appearance again. But that Pestigore goes down. It follows, I could have a hit, but anyway. So I guess one of our warriors is free to move. I think I'll move a Pestigore backwards here. Then this comes down here, and if I now stand up here, I will have a 2 die on him. These are cancelled, and these are now cancelled. Well, this is cancelled, this is the one we're hitting. The blitz... I could do that for the blitz on him. 2 GFIs to blitz him. I blitz him, but that's going the wrong way if I want to force the score early. I guess we can't really count on doing that, so I'm gonna blitz this fella. But first I'm hitting this with him. Hey, we knocked one down. Good. Thank you. And this guy has block, this guy does not have block. Pushing him isn't that good though. Stomping on him is a bad idea. I think that's probably bad too, it's just an extra. I mean, this is better if I'm gonna do that, but that will give him another hit back here instead. So I think I'll just stay here. Maybe we can force him to score on turn 8. Run up here on our turn 6. Well, a bonehead. Helpful. Still has a 2 die, without block though. Makes it. Frees himself up, but he frees us in the process as well. So takes a 2 die over there, that's good. I think he can knock us down, frees up another pestigore. He does have a 2 die here. He takes the 1 die instead. And rolls a skull. That was weird. This guy had a 2 die, right? Because he was the assist. And he could have blitzed with him. Well, I'm not complaining. Could assist one of these, then hit the other, maybe push this guy free. I'm gonna start by moving down here. I don't think he can move far enough this way to be out of our reach. At least not if we include GFIs. Let's try to get some hits in. These two are the obvious choice, so I'm gonna start by doing them. Let's stand this guy up though. Could get a 2 die on him, I suppose, but I kind of don't want to move him in case these fail. That's a push. Stay, so we get a 2 die here. I kind of don't think we get anything more useful to do with our reroll here. Oh, I could have stood up then, since I was doing that. Oh, we got him. Should have blitzed there so I could have assisted up there. That was silly. Big armor though. Oh, that's a stun. Well, now it's a 1 die. Do I want to take a 1 die against block? No. Oh, he scores sometimes. Fair enough. No heroes left for us. 2 turns score with Nurgle in the ring. Got his swords back, and we didn't get our water. Par for the course, I'd say. If he puts every source on the line like this, we have no real answer. Sadly. Putting them this close to the edge, maybe we can do something. We have a guy here, and then use some power. Let's see. I'd rather surf the one with block. Put one guy there, then use a warrior here, an assist here. Someone who cancels him. Uh, This should probably be a Pestigore. I'll put another Pestigore down there, and the third Pestigore. Actually, we have four Pestigores. So something like this. We need to cancel him though. That's your job. We'll need one more on the line. Yes, that's your job. Actually, tie up the Croxigore. Like so. So, what's the plan now? He gets to push him away. If that's a knockdown, you can run this guy up the field. And then we blitz this guy to here. And run up the field. And then perhaps we need to be a little bit closer. You come up, assist over here. And then we push him out. And we have two Pestigores almost in scoring range. But the perfect defense will counter that. Let's see. Extra reroll, that will help. Almost landed in our hands, that would help a lot. And the pickup's gonna be 50%. But the free reroll will help a little bit. So right, this needs to be a knockdown. If this is to work. It is not. I'm gonna reroll that. Maybe we can at least get a surf. Nope, it's not gonna happen. Well, we can still get the surf, I suppose. Stay. We need a push here. Oh, I should have cancelled him first. I thought I'd get a 2-die there. I forgot about 4 strength. Now the thing is, if we want to score, we need to dodge here, otherwise we're not getting through. Could get one guy through, I suppose. Alright, let's go for that. It's so unlikely that we score anyway. Passes in the rain. But if this is an injury, then we can at least do something in the second half. With a scratch on him. Okay. Right, so the important thing here is to get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2. We need to make one GFI at the very least. Probably another. So now he just needs to push us back. I could try to push him. It wouldn't open up a path for me to run through here. But I pushed him as well. You know what? That's probably our best shot here. Nope. No push. Well, if the Croxigore cooperates, he can actually blitz back here, but he's probably blitzing this guy. If he gets him, then the score is gone. That's why you need two score threats. You can only blitz one of them. But at least you have a chance with the other, even if there's 100 guys in front of you. Five. Three. Well, you still have a chance. You didn't blitz him. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's a GFI to blitz. He has 2 rerolls, but still. I mean, what could be easier than catching on a 6 here? And then dodging out on a 6... Wait. It's 4 plus, 5 plus, 5 plus 4 plus 3 plus GFI. So 5 plus 4 plus 3 plus 2 plus. You say the pass is a 5 plus. It's 5 plus, 6 plus, 5 plus, 4 plus, 3 plus, 2 plus. Easiest score we ever had. could make it easier. Well, that's not gonna make it any harder. That's just another 3 plus. That definitely doesn't make it any harder. It's not harder to dodge away from two people than it's to dodge away from one person. Well, we can actually make it quite a bit easier if we blitz this guy. That takes away most of the dodges, especially if we get knocked down. But we still have to make the 6 plus catch after we make the 3 plus dodge, 4 plus pickup, and the 5 plus pass. But I don't see any other good opportunities here. So let's go for it. Go for it twice, actually. So 2 plus, 2 plus. Into a 8 and 9 to get a push at least. Okay, we failed on that part. Well, we get knocked down on one of the skinks. Which didn't do anything. Alright, not the best part. But it's 1-0 and it was their drive. Our guy stays out. And now we're on the offense. I would have made all those 5 pluses and 6 pluses, but I couldn't make the 1 in 9. Right, so we can hit a Saurus with no mighty blow. That's great. He did back off though, he doesn't want to get surfed again. Unless we get a... quick snap. Well, I don't see the point in trying to hit all these Sauruses. We're not gonna injure them, most likely. We'll hit one. Actually, we'll hit two. But Proxymon can be free. Let's pull two of these guys back. Remember, it is raining, so we might have to deal with the ball landing in a bad spot. So if it is a quick snap, I actually want this guy there. Let's switch these two. Because if I can do that, then I can just tag him. I could step up here, tag him as well, and have a two... Actually, no, that won't work. Through then. We could push him to there and then blitz 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah, that'll work. This is just hoping for a quick snap there. But if it's a blitz and the ball lands over here, we're unprotected. So let's hope for not that combination. It is a high kick. It's neither of the ones we need. So let's just put this guy under the ball. Catch him on a 1. No, that's not possible. But we burned a 1. It would otherwise have been a skull or worse. Let's hit this guy. Ooh, look. That's not a skull. It would have been a double skull if we hadn't failed that catch. So, good thing that we got a... And we got 2 SVP. And a warrior. He's gonna level. And we got rid of a Saurus as well. Very good. Now we can blitz the Skink. But either way, we would leave this corner unprotected. Let's not try to pick up the ball first then. It's actually pretty protected right now. I don't think he's picking that up in the rain. Let's just try to blitz the Skink. I'd like to do this last, but we can't really. I'd like to do it last because then I could have picked this option. Now I can't do that. Let's tie up these skinks. Maybe he'll make a skink block or something similar. This cage is not going to be very good. 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm actually going to spread out a bit because if we fumble the ball from here and it lands there, I'd rather have it on the ground there than him fumbling it again, so it lands over here. It has a risk to land over there, yes. So I'm gonna have to do this, and this guy will try to pick up. But first, let's do this two red block. Two red blocks feels very safe, comparatively. He didn't get injured. Fair enough. If I hadn't followed, I could have marked his other skinks. That might have been a smart idea. Force him to do the 1 in 9 dodges. I'm gonna stand here so he can't just blitz this Pestigore and be on the wall. Alright, 50-50. It's a failure. I'm not gonna spend a reroll on that. See, the exact thing I tried to avoid on the other side happened on that side. I had to be there. I could have been there, but then the proxy would have knocked me down. So, couldn't do anything about that. It's a bit unlucky. 50-50. And then, what is it? 1 in 3 chance here. So it's a 1 in 6 to fail it twice. And then, of course, it's only 2 in 8, so 50%. Then we're down to 1 in 12. And he has to drop it forwards, which is 3 in 8. A little bit less than half. So about 1 in 30 that the ball ends up in front of the line like that. That's too bad. But what's the risk? I was aware of it, because I tried to avoid it over there. Stuns him. This pickup's not going to be easy though, it's going to be a 1 in 3 to pick it up. For a skink. For a source, of course, it's 1 in 6. And when I say 1 in 3, I don't mean a 1 in 3 failure this time, it's actually a 1 in 3 to succeed. 5 points. But it's very unlikely that the ball would end up in our hands. He'd probably scatter this way again. So now he can actually have a skink hit here. It's a 1 in 9 to roll a turnover. But he doesn't. Although the way he marked here is going to guarantee that we're still in contact with the skink. He had marked us from there, we could have pushed us away, and the skink would not have been taking another block. Now he chooses to sort of cancel us out here so we can't make the hit, but we can just go in here, cancel, and then make the hit. He's not trying to pick it up then. Fair enough. Now we can do some fancy chain pushes and hope for luck here. Of course we're not going to do something like this anytime soon. So we need a guy here, and an assist here, then we have a 2-die to push him into him onto the ball, and hope that it scatters our way. And then we can hit the skink afterwards. So we need that. I will assist over here for the 2-die. We'll make that first. Well, I did the same thing here, I didn't leave me a choice to free myself up. I'm gonna follow that just to tie these guys up so they can't catch the ball as easily if it bounces their way, because it's gonna bounce now. So we need the assist though. I don't wanna do that. Can you come over here? Could just hit the skink. Actually, that's not. That's just a 1-die. Let's do this 2-die. Push. I guess that's good enough. Now let's see what happens to the ball. I'm gonna follow again to prevent some social control. Oh well, that's not the best spot. That's probably the worst spot. That would have been a little worse. I guess one of his guys catching us would have been bad. I can do this with a 1-die. Let's hit this skink first. Nice. Freeze him up. I'm gonna follow that. I don't want to freeze skink. Alright, let's do this. Push on the 1-die. Ooh, even better. Okay, scatter, come on. I'm not gonna follow that. This game catches it. Okay, that could've been bad. Could've been good. Could've been better. I thought all the disturbing presences would make it hard to catch, but he rolled a 6. Well, pushing doesn't do much anymore. Let's just try to dodge, I suppose. No, couldn't get over the tail. I'm gonna reroll that. We're not gonna get many better chances to get the ball now. This is a free skink. GFI. Made the GFI, doesn't get the knockdown. Well, this skink can run away this way. And there's nothing we can do about that. We can sort of eat up a little bit of the space over there, I guess. Oh wait, now we can just run forward, can't we? Well, it's too late to do anything about it. I can maximum get here. Yeah, this guy moves away. Proxibor moves away. He's off this way. Oh, it doesn't matter really, we've already lost the game. Well, maybe we can tie it with some miracle plays later on. We'll see. We did injure a Saurus, so we have a chance to be up a player. Yeah, he should definitely have stayed in the backfield. My appearance didn't work. Freeze up a Saurus that's going to go over here and knock. And then the skink's gonna dodge away. He's counting on a skink. On a skink making the dodge then. And he did. I think I would have done it the other way around, but Saurus here and then the skink on this side. And Saurus probably there, and then the skink down here. Just in case I failed the skink dodge. But all the skink dodges were fine. Now he has a 2 die. And a Pestigore. Or a Rotter. He chooses the Rotter. Out. So now we might be down a player instead. Unless we get lucky on the wake up blows. Oh, he hits the warrior. I see. So he's gonna hit the Pestigore with less armor and no foul appearance. Doesn't matter, he doesn't get on the push. And what are we left with? Dodges. Chasing skinks. I think chasing skinks and taking a few hits, maybe. Mark a skink. And then... I can't free this guy up. I can free this guy up, but I can't make a path through for these two. So I guess, well, that'll happen after I do this, I suppose. This guy comes down and blitzes this skink. Hey, a pal! Nice. Break armor set on Stunty? You can. But no SPP. Only a 3 on the injury. Hopefully he'll score here and give us another shot at... Oh, another pal. See since you're gonna be stuck there, we can't get through. But we can get a 2 die on this. Sorry. Another pal. This armor luck all game, or bash luck all game. This could have been a good matchup, but that's not going to do anything. I think he just runs in another touchdown. 2-0, he doesn't have to worry, and then he doesn't have to worry about all these skink hits either. And it level up for skink. Black check. Should it be blank check? Ooh, we got a guy back. So that means we're actually even on numbers now. That is not often you get to play with even numbers with Nurgle. Okay, so we have to wait for him. Hey, he's giving us the surf. Well, we have to take the surf. Should have moved this guy. Hit there, that's fine. Then we need to blitz this guy to here. So 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5. We probably want someone to protect it as well, that's this guy. And then the push there. And 2 guys to pick up the ball. Looks good. Confirm. Am I holding to surf now when I probably already lost the game? I don't know. Habit, probably. Okay, this is gonna be difficult. We didn't need this guy for anything in our plan. So I'm gonna bring him back to guard the ball from quick skinks. But then I wanna do this. I think I need to do this first. Oh, nice. Then I need an assist over here. I'll use this, then he also protects surf, counter surf. Then I'm gonna do this, push to here, and then run around here. And push him into the crowd. Pushes into the crowd should work better than pulls into the crowd, right? Yeah. Strange. I heard someone say that as a superstition, and every time I've thought about it and chosen the push, it's been an injury or a knockout. Okay, that would have been nice if it had happened the first time he used that surf. So, do we need to protect this surf? I don't think he's dodging to here to surf us. So let's just make sure that Crocs can't get straight forward. And I'm gonna take this 2 die. Push. I can stay in there. Not in contact. Let's bring a guy up here. And try to pick up the ball. 50%. I think it's worth a reroll at this point. Seeing how we have 3 for 5 turns. Hey, we got it! We got to touch the ball. How many dodges would he need to make? Only one. So we probably stay back here then. Or we put that guy in front. You think he'd dodge through? He only has one dodge there as well. If I put a guy there, maybe. Now it's a ton of dodges, right? It's actually only 2 to get through. If I go here, it's only one. Well, I'm staying back there anyway because I already hit everybody. He could just blitz someone to get through as well. At least he's not missing the ball then. Of course, this is our obvious place to go with the ball. We have best control over there. Just proxy blitz. And injures another warrior. I'm gonna badly hurt. He'll get back next game. Back to even on numbers. We were ahead there for a second. Can you believe it? He's gonna make two GFIs here to tag us. Because he's just gonna stand there and be detecting us, or rather, making it hard for us to get anywhere to make a cage. Well, we can still sneak around this way and make a side cage. He has been careless in putting people where they can be surfed. So if we go on the side, maybe he will repeat that mistake. Although he should have learned by now. He's been surfed twice. Both on kickoffs. Well, we're not going this way. But if we know... that would make kind of risky. We should go through here and put the guy here. One dodge. He's probably gonna have to dodge twice and put the guy over here. If he puts a skink here, it's gonna be real difficult. We're gonna have to blitz that skink and hope to knock it down. I guess we can make a 3 now. Now we'll be rough. He doesn't need to be this aggressive with the skinks, that's an extra dodge we need to make. We could have made it first to there, and then gone there. Two dodges. Instead he dodges an extra time because he can. He didn't even need to reroll with dodge. Okay. Well, if you can punch this guy down, and this guy, and then blitz him, we could have some space to make a cage around here. Well, this is never going to be a 3 die, so let's do that first. Okay, bonus. I need to move because I need to go in through there. Let's see, now this guy needs to go down. Can I afford to make that a 3 die? I suppose if this is a blitz, I think 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, he needs to do that. So what are you doing? You need to be this corner. I'm going here, hopefully. And you need to be this corner, then I need to block him, but that can wait until last. So, I need to get this guy out of the way to get through here though. It's two GFIs as well. So to get to him, I need to knock him out of the way. Yeah, this is probably... one of them can be a 3 die. The other cannot, but I'd rather have him over here then. Okay, is that good enough? Yes, but I can't make it a 3 die now. I can make it a 2 die though. It would have been a 2 die anyway. Push is enough here. Always preferable. Setting up to surf this guy if nothing happens. Alright, I had this guy too. I could have made him a 3 die. So two GFIs. Need to reroll if they fail, of course. Okay, what is this guy going? To lock these skinks in. Kinda like that. After all, we're not gonna win, so the SPP is all that matters. Probably not gonna tie either. Get him off the cage so he can't push a corner off. Okay, well, we have a cage. And since he pushed forward, he is on the wrong side of it. Well, the sources are faster than us. That's a two die. Should probably move the others first, but it's okay. Could have used the block source as well, but it's okay. And now we're going to be surrounded by sources. One there, one there. Making it easier for us to clear it with a chain push. He's making some mistakes, but it's not enough to help us win this match. Yes, please. Would love it if he's still here and help me, but if not, I hope he moves these two so I can get around to there. I'm not gonna... Okay, well, that makes it very easy for me to free him. It's a two die to push here, push there. I guess that doesn't really free me. What is this? His dodging has been pretty good, though. I don't think he can dodge the proxy wall. Well, now it's only a 1-9. So, we're looking at 5 dodges with the skink. 4 dodges with the skink to go here. Only 3. Last one, but he can reroll this, because he didn't fail the same one twice. Okay. Now this is actually going to be easier, because I can do this and have the two die to push. Push him into him, into there, push him there, and I have a two die there and follow, and then he's free to run. Knock this skink down. So this guy's standing up. And surf this skink as well. Let's do the fun stuff first. Show him why you don't need to tag the ball carrier with 5 people. Okay, that's actually going to be a bit annoying because now I don't get a 2 die over here. Oh, it's just a 1 die. Let's do this first. You could actually use that to blitz away instead. Let's see, we would have a 4. We would have a 5 versus 3. That's not enough. We would need to tag him. Well, if this is a pow pow, then maybe. It's not. Well, if he chooses not to dodge, then maybe. He did choose not to dodge, right? Okay, good. So then that means this guy can come over here, and I could get this. Let's hope we can make this GFI. We still have our reroll. Now I need a push or better here to cancel him. It's better than push. That means this is now a 3 die, which gives us a little bit of a better shot. And a pow, which is the ideal result here. Sadly, no armor break. The armor break would have stopped him from using that skink to follow us, but I think we still run. And we don't take this, because if it's a skull... Actually, you can still free this guy by hitting here with the 2 die. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2. So I guess we do take this. It's a push or better, which it is. And I'm going to push this guy to here and follow. That'll stop him from freeing himself here. Okay, well, things worked out. But he can still dodge this skink, Dodge this skink. Dodge this skink and hit us. First one go. Can I blitz with a one die if these three dodges are okay? To make three dodges here as well. Or is that? No, it's not chain push. We're just gonna use our own weapon against us, but that could actually be fleeing. Yeah, because now he has a two die healer. So at least it's a 2+ to make the foul appearance, which he did. And the push is not gonna help. Actually, it would have. If you pushed him there and then knocked this guy down, he could have gone around without any dodges. But I guess one dodge is pretty much safe, comparatively. Ooh, he blitzed there, so he's not gonna blitz the book anyway. Giving us a single dodge to go free. After we failed that, reroll, okay. Expenses reroll. Guess we're gonna have to dodge here then. We're not close enough to hit him. No GFIs. And I'm not risking GFIs. That's not gonna make the dodge any harder. If he goes there though, it will. Actually no, then we just blitz him. No, that would be a pretty bad blitz. Look at it. Okay. Failed the dodge. And stunned himself. Can we do anything to free ourselves up easier than with a dodge? We need to get both of these off or somehow push ourselves away. Would be nice to fill all these three and then blitz from here, pushing him into him and then going there. But we can't get that far. This guy's too far away. He needs one GFI just to tag. This guy needs two GFIs to tag. I need a dodge and a GFI. Do we hit a skink first? I think so, yes. We need an SP on our warriors. Can we make it a 3 die? We can cancel him and get an assist, so yes. I'll use this guy for the assist. No, actually, I'll run him up and use this guy for the assist. Just in case we manage to recover somehow. So this should be 3 now, 1 assist, no assists for him. 5 versus 2. SPP? SPP? But I'm not yet. Something at least. Without dodging, we're not doing that. So we're just doing this then. 3 SPP on a Festivore? Yes. And I guess we have one turn to tie the game up. If it's a riot, we get two turns. So there is a theoretical chance. You get a blitz, we can do it. Now he wakes up, of course. And our guy stays out. Go for the course. If we're going to score in one turn, we're gonna have to set up for it. But the risk is that he just runs through and scores with a skink. Do we care if we lose 3-1? I don't. I'd rather have the chance to go 2-2 in a miracle turn of events. So I'm actually gonna put my warrior on the line this time because I want the Pestigors to be available to go up in case of a good, fortunate kickoff event. We're gonna keep these guys here so they can at least have a chance to blitz a skink that goes through, or any skink that he sends up to make a two-turn. Maybe I should have kept the warriors back to make the catch harder, but then again, I just said I don't care if it's 3-1 or 2-1. If it was 1-1 right now, I should probably have tried to protect the tie. Skinks on the line, two of them, one in the backfield. He's already caught it in our disturbing auras, disturbing presences once. So he's trying to go through on this side. If we're lucky, he moves this guy as well. Goes all in on this side to score again. Okay. You want the ball to be on this side. Then again, giving him a free pickup. I'm gonna favor that side a little bit. Hope we don't get the bad roll. Defense. I don't want to switch sides. No, wait. We're the defenders. Yeah, we're definitely going up here. Do I actually want to tie him up with my warriors, or do I want to free my warriors? I think I want to tie him up with my warriors. Forcing him to take blocks instead of stuff. That will increase the chance that we actually get to the ball here. I guess we can afford to keep one festival back now that we know that it's a path through. These three are our scoring threats. Come on, go for the pickup first. He didn't, definitely didn't do that on his first drive, so we couldn't expect him to do that. And yeah, that'll probably stop us. We can blitz one of them and then send someone else to him. Get on the ball, makes things harder. And there's the pickup. We failed it. We roll. And we get a chance. Chance is again. Ah, it lands in both of the attack missiles now, so our pickup's gonna be super difficult. So difficult that I in fact want to try to 2GFI blitz this guy onto the ball and hope it lands over here. And then we're gonna dodge through here and hope for luck. Two GFIs, reroll of course if it fails. Probably should have blitzed him in such a way that I could have pushed him off the wall. Well, let's go for the scatter and hope it lands in only one tackle cells. So not here. We'll have to do with that, I guess. Let's hit a skink with a 3 die, just for the SPP chance. Didn't get it. He can't score now, so we don't have to really worry about that. If we want to try to get 2 SPP on a Rotter, I don't care. Let's just try to go through. Here. And. Yes, we have to try to catch it on this guy. Oh wow, double six. I think it's more important to tie this guy up, right? He's gonna try and stop us. Dodging away doesn't really accomplish much. But we have our reroll. We should probably be aggressive as long as we have our reroll. I go this way so he can't reach us. Oh wow, good. And now this guy comes through here. Wow, that worked too. I think I'll go here so he can't go in between us. I guess if you do that and then blitz, then at least these two can score. Should I move up one? Still have my reroll. Okay, well, that's nice. I'm gonna try to knock this guy down so I can run this guy up and maybe get a better screen here. That didn't work. I don't want to free him, but now I can tag him, so risk failure there. I'm gonna try to dodge, because I still have my reroll. Still have my reroll. So I'm gonna try to dodge again. Okay, well, I'm gonna use my reroll. I still have one from the last time. So I basically did very risky stuff until I lost my reroll, and he doesn't do anything here, because these guys can run between. So I'm gonna try one more GFI. Okay, that's enough. I don't want to risk another GFI. These blocks would be pretty bad, since a failure would allow him to free one of these players. No, you can't do that. Well, you could try. So one option here is to bring this guy into assist. Use a skink with a 2 die there, and then blitz the ball carrier with your 3 Saurus. He takes a Cruxy block. I guess he had block there. Block out. Squiffle. 2 dice. We could actually tie this. Wait, what? Oh no, that was turn 16, of course. Why was I... I probably didn't have 2 turns. He must have been real amused that we did all that. Right, we were 1 turn off of tying the game. And SPP on a rotter. Great. That's what we want to build our team. But we did get 1 level up, I believe. He got a level up on Osiris. I thought he conceded there because I thought it was another turn. That would have been interesting. Yes, Guffle's gonna level up, but that's all. So 1 level up after 3 games, that's pretty good. And it's on another warrior. We're gonna roll this the way I usually do this, if you haven't seen any other series, is I roll the level ups at the beginning of the video. That'll make it, first of all, it's sort of a cliffhanger for the next video, and also it, makes it so those who just want to see the team advancement, what happens, they only have to watch the beginning of the video, I guess. Can skip the actual game. But yeah, we're starting to move places with our 0-2-1 record. Might be top Nurgle with that, I don't know. No, there's probably people who can win with Nurgle when they're fresh. I'm not one of them. So anyway, thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I will see you again next time.